The ShakeAlert earthquake early warning system has received a milestone upgrade, the addition of an entirely different type of sensor. Managed by the United States Geological Survey and its partners, ShakeAlert is a system that detects seismic waves at the sensor's nearest an earthquake's epicenter, triggering an alert that can reach people farther away before strong shaking reaches them, giving them seconds of valuable time to take protective actions. Up to this point, ShakeAlert has utilized networks of seismometers to detect shaking and estimate earthquake magnitude and location. But GPS stations that measure how far the ground moves during an earthquake are now also connected to ShakeAlert, improving its ability to accurately estimate magnitude for the largest earthquakes.
GPS is incredibly important for ShakeAlert because it does not saturate for the biggest magnitude earthquakes. So you can record a magnitude 6, you can record a magnitude 9 earthquake, and we'll faithfully record the full ground motion history of this event. Seismometers, strong ground motion observations generally don't capture this, so they'll saturate out at a 7 or 7.5.
So we fill that gap for very large destructive earthquakes, and there's no delay. Like if we're sitting on top of a magnitude 9, we know it's a magnitude 9 within seconds, as opposed to, you know, waiting sometimes minutes or even tens of minutes before you can determine how big the earthquake is. So it fills that hole at the very top for large destructive earthquakes.
The goal is to be able to give as much warning to users that shaking is coming to their location. And so the more quickly we can do that and the more accurately, the better. In the early 2000s, we already knew that high-rate GPS could also give important information, but the growth of real-time networks has really contributed to it being possible now. We didn't have nearly as many stations back then, and they weren't transmitting data in real time. So technologically speaking, we've advanced a lot, and now we have an opportunity. For the first algorithm that we're working on to incorporate into ShakeAlert, just in terms of the network, we need to have good coverage throughout the ShakeAlert region.
So GFAST is an algorithm I developed that takes the peak ground displacement observations from GPS and says something about the magnitude of the earthquake. It's a scaling law between the distance from an earthquake, the magnitude, and the peak ground displacement. And so at a given distance, for bigger and bigger earthquakes, you expect more peak ground displacement.
EarthScope, as the operator of the National Science Foundation's Gage facility, maintains a number of these GPS stations as part of the Network of the Americas. This network is used to study plate tectonics, earthquakes, and many other earth processes. For real-time data processing and upgrades to use additional GNSS satellites have improved its ability to rapidly detect earthquakes. Our newly designed data system streams this data to the ShakeAlert Processing Center. After some time running in parallel behind the live system to test the earthquake detection algorithm developed by the team of researchers, GPS stations are now actively contributing to the delivery of alerts.
To detect the earthquake, we have to know how the station moved as quickly as possible. So the technical hurdles here are, you know, it's got to be, you have to have good monumentation that's not going to crumble in a large earthquake, say if it shifts 5 meters in a few seconds. The station has to run through the earthquake, it has to stay online during the earthquake. So these are all sort of engineering things that we have to tackle at the site itself. And then once we tackle those problems, we have to collect the data with very low latency. The data is not a position that we collect, it's a, you know, it's raw data, so we have to process the data. And then we have to combine the data into a product that tells us something about the size of the earthquake. And these are all significant steps in the chain, and we have to do this whole thing in, say, less than 5 or 6 seconds.
Well, I think it's just exciting that we're finding new ways to improve the system by bringing in new algorithms, by bringing in new kinds of data. And so it's been exciting to see things really mature over the last several years to really start to think about how being able to infer the source characteristics, for example, can translate into a good estimate of ground shaking, where a user is.
Well, what I think makes exciting about ShakeAlert, and in particular, the geodesy component of ShakeAlert, which is what we're involved with, is like it for one, it's a direct contribution of our field back to humanity. For large destructive earthquakes, we can provide a real warning that it can save lives, it can potentially save billions of dollars. And it's like a demonstration of the science that we have been working on for the past 40 years, you know, contributing directly back to society. You know, a demonstration was a good investment.
To learn more about ShakeAlert, the areas it covers, and how to make sure you receive alerts on your cell phone, visit usgs.gov/ShakeAlert.